Hi, my name is Vivek and welcome to my YouTube channel. This is the sixth episode to create a responsive website using Vuetify. In the previous episode, we worked on gallery using images component. Today, we'll be working on latest post using cart component. First of all, we'll create a new component called latest post. Go to the components folder and copy and paste gallery.view and rename it to latestpost.view. Now you can open this latestpost.view and change the name from gallery to latestpost. Then you can remove all the content which starts and end with 0 and add just latest post so that we can test. And also you can remove all the content from this items array. Now you can open this app.view. And just after gallery, you can add latest post. Then you can import latest post from latest post component. And finally add latest post inside this components object. Now if you check the site, your components will be ready to use. Now open the Vuetify website, click on Get Started, click on UI component, and then click on this cards. Now you can scroll down and select anything which is close to your design. I'll use the one called Media with Text. So click on View Source and then select and copy everything that starts and ends with fee card. Now you can open latestpost.view and paste it over here. Then you can also change the title from gallery to latest post. And you can also change the class name from gallery block to latest post block, because in index.scss I have added a few styles for latest post block. Now if you check the site, you should see the card over here. Here you go. Now to make this gray background full width, you have to add this fee container inside this block class. And in order to reduce this gap, I think you might have to do the same for this gallery.view as well. Here we go. It looks much better than before now. Now we can remove the max weight and add outline if you want to remove this box shadow and add a border. Like this. Then we can use fee row and fee call if we want to use a grid system. 0. Then vehicle. Then inside this vehicle, you can add calls and add some column number. I will add 4 according to our design. Now let's add dynamic content by adding data in items object. We need ID, title, subtitle, description and image source. So now once we get our data, we can use for loop in vehicle. So it will be item in items. Then we need key, which is item.id. Now you can use interpolation to show the data. The title will be item.title. Subtitle will be item.subtitle. Yep. And the description will be item.description. Then we have got this 2 button, and I can remove any one of them, and then I can change the color from orange to primary and change the button name from share to more. So let's have a quick look at the preview now. So everything is working so far except this images. For this images, we can either use vbind source and image source over here, or you can simply add colon src for shortcut. Now let's look at the site, and you can see the images over here, and now we can compare it to our original design as well, and they both seems exactly the same now. Great. This is the end of this session. In the next session, I will show you how to work on footer using footer component. Feel free to comment below if you have any questions. Also, please don't forget to like and subscribe to my channel to get more tutorials in the future. Thank you.